진짜 소식입니다. 다들 이분 기억하시죠?
Hi, it's me.
주전장.
이 주전장 영화를 만든 감독이 일본인이거든요. 근데 어저께 저한테 연락이 오더라고요. 자기 한국에 온다고. 그래서 오늘 보기로 했습니다. 이번에는 가볍게 늘 하던 대로 승부수 진행해보도록 하겠습니다. 저도 이 감독님을 처음 보는 거거든요. 실제로 보는 감독님은 어떤 모습일지 굉장히 궁금한데 지금 바로 함께 출발해보죠. Let's go!
유튜버.
Yeah, I'm YouTuber.
Glad to finally meet you in person.
In the flesh.
Yeah, this is my first time back in Korea since the pandemic.
But finally.
Yeah. I'm so happy to be here. We had the screening yesterday. Q&A was really good.
What do usual students ask about?
I mean, there's no usual because I've been to over 70 universities in Europe and the U.S.
What was the most shocking question?
From a Korean?
Or Japanese?
I've done so many of these Q&As.
There's one thing memorable question.
Surprisingly, not that many shocking questions. I think that one of the more interesting reactions I got was when I was in Sweden, there was an old man. He was like, my wife is Japanese. This is all a lie. And I was like, sir, did you watch the movie? It was really strange. Sometimes there's just like strange people. I think in Canada, there was a guy, he doesn't understand why Japanese people are nationalists because everyone is Chinese. And it was funny because there was a Japanese history professor in the audience, and she was just like, oh my god. But I think students always have very usually sharp questions. They want to know more about the comfort women issue or what more they can do to help. It's always been good. I don't think I've ever been like really shocked by a student's question. I think the shock comes more from like Japanese students.
Oh.
They're always saying that I was shocked that I didn't know about this. I didn't know, you know. Many times they say they have to watch it 2-3 times.
Because they don't know anything about it.
Right, exactly, yeah. And they just believe that government was doing the right thing. So if you believe that Abe is doing the right thing, that means that if the media is criticizing Korea, that means that Koreans must be bad, right? If you trust the government.
Yeah.
So that's how I think kind of racism sort of gets created, you know.
Sorry, I forgot the reason why you started this film.
Well, the film was because I cared about like Japan-Korea relations, and I thought maybe if Japanese and Korean people can kind of understand more about the issue.
I mean, for real.
For real?
Yeah, for real. There's a spark always. I saw the video, YouTube video.
A racism in Japan.
A lot of people in Japan call disposable cameras baka-chon cameras. Baka means stupid or idiot. And chon is a derogatory term for Korean people. It means a camera so easy to use that even an idiot Korean person can use it.
How did it happen?
I just noticed that in Japan, they don't really talk about racism. And they just don't know anything about racism, even though they're teachers.
They don't know the definition of racism?
They don't think about racism in their own country. They think racism is like a American thing. Or
despite the fact that they are discriminating against Korean people in Japan.
Yeah. And at the time, I lived in Okinawa. Okinawan people get discriminated against by mainland Japanese. But for some reason, they just thought like, oh, that was a bad time in the past. They didn't make the connection that that was like racism. And then, you know, when I talked about it, then they kind of understood more. Like my students understood more about racism. Even to this day, Japanese mainland people discriminate against Okinawan in very subtle ways, but they still do. Because of that, I thought, oh, maybe I should make a video about it on YouTube. Because before, the only other video on racism in Japan was this white Canadian girl who said, I never experienced racism, so there's no racism. And then all the comments are like Japanese people saying, oh, you're right.
Because she's white.
Exactly, yeah. And then I made my video. Yeah, I got attacked a lot by Japanese right-wingers a lot.
So that's the spark.
That's not the spark. I have no like feeling of like revenge or anything. In between making that video and making the movie, Shusenjo, I became a monk in Thailand. Yeah. So yeah, I kind of let go all the feelings, you know? And I was just wanting to help bring peace in the world and peace in myself, you know? And so I thought, how can I help Korea and Japan, you know? That's honestly the feeling I had.
Wow.
So yeah.
That's the greatest reason I ever had heard.
You know, Japanese people should know about their history.
But they don't teach.
Of course, that part of history they don't teach. So I think they have a right to know. They should know. Because otherwise, if you're a young Japanese student and you don't know your history, and you go abroad somewhere and somebody asks you about it, and then you don't know anything, you just look like an idiot. It's like if you're a German and then you go to another country and somebody says, oh, what do you think about the Holocaust? Or what do you think about, you know, Nazism? And then
we didn't do that.
Yeah, yeah. You look like an idiot. So I think it's important for Japanese youth to know about what happened. Or not just Japanese people, but people in general to know about their history so that they can understand what's going on now. You know, the politicians, everybody's trying to control you through the media somehow. So I think when you know the history, it's harder to be controlled because you know what's behind it, you know?
Your humanity is so great. Is there anything inconvenient when you're leaving Japan?
Very hard to make friends in Japan. It's a different, I mean, in America, it's very easy to make friends, a lot of friends. Yeah, yeah, yeah. But at the same time, the friendship is a little more superficial.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Right? But in Japan, it's harder to make friends, but it might be more deep if you make a friend.
It's the same in Korea.
Same in Korea, yeah, yeah. To meet new people, to meet new friends in Japan, it is challenging. Most of my friends are like foreign friends.
일본인 친구는 많이 사귀었어?
사실은 대부분 일본에서 사는 한국 사람들.
You know.
Do you have a Korean friend?
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Minus
me. Of course. Yeah, I have more than one.
How is it possible? Because you live in Japan.
He lives in Japan. He used to be a YouTuber, too.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Did he quit?
He quit, yeah.
Why?
Maybe too much stress.
I understand.
Yeah. It's unstable, right?
Yeah, unstable, stress.
He did well, I think. He couldn't continue, I think. So he became like a programmer.
What's the shocking thing you have seen in Korea?
I was really surprised. I went to the Comfort Women statue. They have the Wednesday protest every Wednesday, and then now there's a counter protest by the Korean right-wingers. I was so surprised because when I went there in 2015, they didn't have that. It was crazy. The statue is there and there's like barricades all around the statue. You can't even access the statue anymore. Yeah, it's crazy. And then the space next to the statue is taken by the right-wingers or the conservative, or I don't know, like...
The funny thing is right-wingers usually, normally, they're defending their country.
Right, right, patriot, yeah.
Taking their own side all the time. But in Korea, right-wingers taking America. Japanese side.
And America side. It's unique. Korean uniqueness. Korean politics is super interesting. I just feel like Korean politics moves so quickly. In Japan, it's so slow.
Everything is slow.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
System is slow. Process is slow.
Exactly, yeah. In Korea, so fast.
Is it not inconvenient? The slow system.
Yeah, it feels inconvenient. But at the same time, there is some benefit to slowness, I think. I mean, it's just different because, like, for instance, when my movie came out in Korea, it came and then it was shown and a lot of people came to watch it and then it's gone and move on to the next thing.
Right?
But in Japan, some movie theaters show my film for 8 months, 9 months, long time. So it's... You know?
Wow.
You know, that kind of thing. Like in Korea, like the news is really fast. I was doing the interview, like press conference. While we're doing the press conference, already the article is coming out about me, you know? We haven't even finished yet, and it's already coming out. It's amazing how fast.
Welcome to Korea.
In Japan, sometimes a journalist will contact us and write an article. We'll say, when is the article coming? 2 weeks later, 3 weeks later. Japanese people are very, like, rule-based, you know? That's such a, like, difference between Japan and Korea. Japan is, like, very tight with a lot of things, but Korea is very flexible. I mean, this is a small example. I went to the gym, and I told the gym person, I would like to get a day pass. In Korea, they said, oh, we don't do a day pass. And I said, okay. So then I was gonna leave. But they said, oh, you can work out for free.
Oh.
I was like, oh, really? But in Japan, if there's no day pass, then you can't, you know, work out there. They would never say, just come for free.
Yeah, because they always follow the book.
Yeah. But I feel like with Korea, there's more bending of the rules.
You're independent.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
What's the good thing about living in Japan?
Well, compared to America, it's way safer. I really like the toilets.
They're clean.
So clean. Everywhere you go, it's clean. Even in the station, it's clean.
True, true.
So that's really great about... Actually, Japanese food is really good because the average quality is very high, and it's not so expensive because we don't tip.
Compared to Korea, it's expensive. Because we have free dishes, I mean, free side dishes.
Right,
dishes,
right.
But in Japan, they don't.
Right.
Besides, after finishing the side dish, which is a reddish thing, I ask, can I get more?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. No, 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 no. You have to pay. Yeah, right. Yeah, that part, yeah, yeah. But in the US, yeah, it's so expensive now. You know, you have to tip and everything. Like, I was in San Francisco. I went to Chinatown for lunch, and it was like $40.
$40?
And then when I told my friend who's from San Francisco, I said, my lunch cost $40 without tip. And she said, well, at least it wasn't $50. That's crazy. One person, lunch, just lunch. I mean, the same lunch in Japan would have been $12. It's absolutely crazy. You know, Americans are very friendly, but also they have a bit of a chip on their shoulder. There's always a possibility of a fight. There's always that aggression. So like, I was in Hawaii. Do you know the crosswalk? And the guy, he parked a little too much into the crosswalk, you know? And so we had to go around the car. As we're going behind the car, he wanted to pull back because he wanted to get out of the way, right? And then so he was slowly going back, but the person walking kind of got bumped a little bit, just a little bit. And then he freaks out. Smacks the car and he's like, you almost hit me. We're in Hawaii. It's like peaceful. It's like, and then they're freaking out on each other. That's something that you don't see in Japan that often.
Because they're hiding their true mind.
Yeah. Maybe they go home and they...
That's a scary thing because hiding their true color is a little risky.
I do think that in Japan, every once in a while, there's like a, for instance, Abe got shot. That kind of thing is crazy. It's insane. You know, you can't imagine it, especially in Japan, but it happens because underneath the surface, it's boiling, you know? That's why I have to be careful. You know, I got a tweet the other day when I was advertising the screening in Korea. Somebody tweeted like, why are you still alive kind of thing.
How could you put up with all this shit?
I do think my faith in humanity has gone down a lot.
What was the most impressive thing in Korea?
Korean chicken is amazing. I don't really care about fried chicken. And then I tried and I was like, oh my god, this is amazing. This is the best chicken I've ever had. Gyocheon chicken.
Is it your favorite?
Well, I've never tried any other one.
Really?
Yeah, I've only had gyocheon. But I heard that some of the gyocheon branches are not so good these days.
Yeah.
So gyocheon chicken, please, you know, get back to being good, you know. Like. And then luckily, the one I went to a couple days ago, it was amazing, so.
EHC is my favorite. Amazing.
Yeah. I like how Koreans express themselves because you don't get that so much in Japan. I feel like I can really get a feeling of people's character here. If they don't like something, they show. It's really nice. I feel like Koreans are very like energetic. If you go to like a convenience store in Japan, even if they hate their life, they hate their job, they'll still be very polite. But sometimes it feels very robotic. But like in Korea, I like that sometimes the convenience store person is just like, meh. I kind of like it. I don't know why. He's showing how he feels.
I don't like it.
Maybe if I live here, I don't like it. I don't know, but like coming from Japan.
You like sushi?
Sushi, yeah, of course. I've never had sushi in Korea, actually.
Really?
No.
The radioactive water is...
It makes it better, tastes better. Maybe it makes your tongue a little tingle on your tongue or something.
So what's the biggest issue in Japan right now?
The Fukushima thing was a big issue.
Even in Japan?
Yeah, when it was happening, yeah.
Okay, let's go get some dinner.
I'm hungry. Ah.